Hi there. Thanks for watching today. Natalie Rizzo here. Today we're going to talk about a topic I get asked about a lot, inflammation. I'm a registered dietitian who works with a ton of athletes, and I always get questions from, should I go on Tom Brady's anti-inflammatory diet to, how do I reduce inflammation after my long runs? And I have all the answers for you. We're going to talk about three things you should know about inflammation, and then stick around until the end. So I'm going to use all of these ingredients in front of me to make an inflammation-fighting lettuce wrap. But first, let's dive into those three things you should know about this buzzy nutrition word, inflammation. So number one, we see the word inflammation everywhere, from headlines to TV. What exactly is inflammation? That's the first thing that we should know before we even address how to battle it. So inflammation can be a good thing and it can be a bad thing. There's two different types of inflammation. One is called acute inflammation. And that is the type of inflammation that happens to athletes after a workout. During your run, you put some stress on your joints and on your muscles. Your body's response to that stress is to send out white blood cells and cause some inflammation to deal with the stress in those joints. That type of inflammation is actually a good thing. That is a healing process in the body. The one thing is with that type of inflammation, it tends to hurt a little bit, right? So we want to reduce that inflammation because we don't want to deal with the pain after a workout. The other type of inflammation is chronic inflammation. This is the bad kind of inflammation that causes diseases. So people who suffer from inflammation all the time because they have some sort of chronic condition or they're overweight or obese, they always have inflammation in the body, and that inflammation can lead to more serious diseases. We want to include some anti-inflammatory foods to reduce that inflammation and make you a little bit healthier. And of course, these types of foods are good for a variety of different things, but they really help fight inflammation. So that's number one. The second thing you should know about inflammation is a term called antioxidants. So you probably always hear antioxidants and inflammation together, or maybe you hear anti-inflammatory foods and antioxidants. They're basically the same thing. Antioxidants are compounds that help fight off inflammation. So basically, certain things oxidize in the body, and that's a bad thing, and antioxidants fight those things off. Where do antioxidants come from? They come from food. So we hear of antioxidants in things like dark chocolate, wine, cocoa, coffee, but it's also abundant in different fruits and vegetables. So I have some of these fruits and vegetables here, and we're going to make something with foods that are really rich in antioxidants. Now, the third thing you should know about inflammation is, how do you fight it? How do you keep inflammation at bay? And there's really three things you can do. So after a long run, a tough swim, a tough cycling session, if you feel a little bit of inflammation in your joints, you can ice them. So inflammation kind of causes some pain, swelling, redness. Icing helps to reduce all of those things. So for myself, I ice my knees after every long run I take, really just preventatively to reduce that inflammation. The other thing is something that a lot of people refer to as vitamin I, which is otherwise known as ibuprofen. Ibuprofen helps to reduce inflammation in the body. The thing is, it's a medication, it's a pill, you don't want to take it all that often. And I totally understand that. I don't love taking pills all that often. And I think that we can do things with food that we don't necessarily need medication for. But in severe circumstances, they will give ibuprofen to fight inflammation. The third thing is food. Our lovely, colorful food we have here fights inflammation. So what I want you to remember about food and inflammation is, the darker the food, the more it fights off inflammation. So you have things like dark berries, blueberries, strawberries, dark root vegetables, beets, dark leafy greens like our collard green here, carrots, cabbage. They have all different types of antioxidants in them that will come with different names like polyphenols, flavonoids, and the simple vitamins like vitamin E and vitamin A are also antioxidants. So if you eat a diet that has tons of fruits and vegetables, you will get your antioxidants. As well as something else people don't realize is the healthy fats have antioxidants in them. So here we have some avocado, some pumpkin seeds. These help with inflammation in the body. The anti-inflammatory diets, a lot of times have these wonderful fruits and vegetables and healthy fats in them. And we're going to make something with all of these ingredients. We're going to make a delicious anti-inflammatory lettuce wrap. So I'm going to bring you a little closer and show you how to make this wonderful lettuce wrap. Okay, first you start with a collard green. I cut off some of the stem here to make this a little easier to wrap, just because it's really thick and chewy. So we cut off some of that. So we just put this down. Then we're gonna take some carrots, which have a lot of vitamin A, which is an anti-inflammatory or an antioxidant. And we're gonna lay those along the stem. Then we're going to take some cabbage, which is dark purple and full of antioxidants. We're gonna lay that in there. Then, remember what I said about our healthy fats? We're gonna take some avocado, spoon that out, put that in there. Take a roasted red pepper or two. They have some antioxidants in there, but they also just taste deliciously sweet. Lay that in there. Top it with whatever seeds you like. I like some pumpkin seeds here. I'm gonna sprinkle those on there. And then just for a little extra flavor, we're gonna add a little honey mustard dressing. Got some olive oil in there for the healthy fats. And that's it, you wrap it all up. So it's as simple as that to beat inflammation. Putting together a few simple ingredients into a tasty wrap that you can have before or after a workout or as an afternoon snack. I hope this demystifies the word inflammation for you and gives you some sort of an idea about anti-inflammatory foods. I'm gonna dig into this lettuce wrap right now. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. See you next time.